Hello. Welcome, esteemed members of the practical and master class. Unlike any other joint, the ankle relies extensively on its passive structures. These include the intricate network of ligaments and the specialized geometry of the bones. This complex design efficiently supports prolonged standing and conserves energy by minimizing the need for active muscular engagement. The ligaments, in particular, ensure robust stability and play a crucial role in proprioception, providing sensory feedback essential for precise movements. This intricate system makes the ankle exceptionally well-suited to support activities like standing, walking, and running, making it a key factor in human locomotion and endurance. The ankle continuously monitors and responds to dynamic changes in balance, detecting imbalances and sending signals to the central nervous system, which then coordinates motor responses to restore equilibrium. Thus, understanding the ligaments and bony structures of the ankle is crucial for pain doctors, much like comprehending the dynamic interplay of the shoulder girdle muscles. Despite their crucial role in stability, the ankle's ligaments are always exposed to challenges and vulnerable to injury during everyday activities. This vulnerability underscores the importance of understanding and studying these ligaments for effective pain management and treatment. The most common and potentially debilitating mechanism of injury to the ankle ligaments is inversion of the foot. With this mechanism of injury, the anterior talofibular ligament is the first or only ligament to sustain injury. A total rupture involves the calcaneofibular ligament and the posterior talofibular ligaments. An eversion injury will cause damage to the deltoid ligaments, while a hyper-dorsiflexion trauma might cause an injury to the syndesmotic ligament. In my clinical practice and during ultrasound examinations, I have primarily focused on the anterior tibiofibular ligament, the lateral calcaneofibular ligament, and the deltoid ligament. However, I now realize the importance of studying other ligaments more thoroughly. A few years ago, I successfully treated the posterior inferior tibiofibular ligament. This achievement would not have been possible without a detailed understanding of both the anterior and posterior inferior tibiofibular ligaments. This experience has taught me the necessity of broadening our study of the ankle ligaments. If you need to remember these structures, I recommend replaying this video repeatedly until you fully grasp their complexities. Let's start this comprehensive study now. Here are key elements for understanding ankle ligaments more systematically. Our bodies typically exhibit symmetrical features, which aid in organizing and remembering ligament systems. Here are some practical tips to systematize the study of ankle ligaments. First, divide the ligaments by their anatomical position, lateral, medial, and interspace ligaments. Second, the ligaments are categorized based on the bones they connect to. For the lateral ankle, where the lateral malleolus is a crucial structure, there are four major bones: fibula, talus, calcaneus, and cuboid. The links between them include fibula to talus, fibula to calcaneus, talus to calcaneus, and calcaneus to the cuboid bone. For the medial ankle, the medial malleolus serves as the core landmark. Here, the major bones are the tibia, talus, calcaneus, and navicular bone, with links from the tibia to talus, tibia to calcaneus, tibia to navicular bone, talus to calcaneus, and calcaneus to navicular bone. Third, symmetry should be utilized: anterior, posterior, medial, and lateral. For instance, the anterior and posterior relation relates to the anterior and posterior inferior tibiofibular ligament, the anterior and posterior tibiotalar ligament, and the anterior and posterior talofibular ligament. By changing fibula to tibia, you catch symmetric relationships, such as changing the anterior talofibular ligament to the anterior tibiotalar ligament, the posterior talofibular ligament to the posterior tibiotalar ligament, and the lateral calcaneofibular ligament to a talocalcaneal ligament. These methods help streamline the study of ankle ligaments and improve recall and understanding of their functions with ankle disorders. Did I speak too quickly? I will repeat one more slowly. First, divide the ligaments by their anatomical position: lateral, medial, posterior, and interspace ligaments. Second, the ligaments are categorized based on the bones they connect to. For the lateral ankle, where the lateral malleolus is a crucial structure, there are four major bones: fibula, talus, calcaneus, and cuboid. The links between them include fibula to talus, fibula to calcaneus, talus to calcaneus, and calcaneus to the cuboid bone. For the medial ankle, the medial malleolus serves as the core landmark. Here, the major bones are the tibia, talus, calcaneus, and navicular bone, with links from the tibia to talus, tibia to calcaneus, tibia to navicular bone, talus to calcaneus, and calcaneus to navicular bone. Third, symmetry should be utilized: anterior, posterior, medial, and lateral. For instance, the anterior and posterior relation relates to the anterior and posterior inferior tibiofibular ligament. The anterior and posterior tibiotalar ligament, and the anterior and posterior talofibular ligament. By changing fibula to tibia, you catch symmetric relationships, such as changing the anterior talofibular ligament to the anterior tibiotalar ligament, the posterior talofibular ligament to the posterior tibiotalar ligament, and the lateral calcaneofibular ligament to a talocalcaneal ligament. Disclosure: I have utilized multiple images from these articles, which feature beautifully detailed dissections and illustrations. I extend my thanks for their contributions. Let's examine each structure. I will show you the dissection images and a brief description of the anatomy, and you will have time to observe. Lateral ankle. Anterior inferior talofibular ligaments with inferior fascicle. This ligament spans obliquely from the lateral tibia's anterior region to the medial fibula's anterior part at their distal ends, effectively bridging the lower portions of these two bones. Integral to the anterior inferior talofibular ligament is its inferior fascicle, composed of thinner, elongated extensions that provide additional reinforcement. Positioned at the lower part of the ligament, these fascicles enhance the primary function of the anterior inferior talofibular ligament by further securing the tibiofibular syndesmosis. The anterior inferior talofibular ligament and its inferior fascicles stabilize the distal tibiofibular joint. Please observe the normal variation of the anterior inferior talofibular ligament and inferior fascicles. Anterior talofibular ligament. It connects the anterior aspect of the lateral malleolus of the fibula to the talus's neck. It is the most frequently injured ligament during ankle sprains, primarily due to its position and the stress placed upon it during inversion injuries. Structurally, the ATFL comprises multiple fascicles or bundles of fibers, which can vary in number and orientation among individuals. So, do not expect a single ligament strand when undergoing ultrasound scanning. Many illustrations show the ATFL as a single strand, which can cause confusion or misunderstood ultrasound features. Lateral calcaneofibular ligament. It extends from the lateral malleolus downwards to the lateral surface of the calcaneus. Unlike other ligaments in the ankle, the CFL is oriented more vertically, creating a distinct angle with the talus and the subtalar joint. This positioning allows the CFL to stabilize the ankle joint and subtalar joint, providing multidirectional stability. When you shift your focus from the anterior talofibular ligament to the lateral calcaneofibular ligament while ankle ultrasound scanning, you may notice that these two ligaments are not distinctly separated at the distal tip of the lateral malleolus. This observation could be attributed to two factors: firstly, the extension of the ATFL towards the inferior region, and secondly, the presence of the underlying talocalcaneal ligament. Therefore, you might observe a continuous thick capsular structure when you pivot your ultrasound probe at the lateral malleolus. Is it difficult to understand? I will demonstrate cases related to this conversation in the next ultrasound examination. I have observed some patients who experience pain at the lateral malleolus tip without apparent tear in the anterior talofibular or lateral calcaneofibular ligament's main body. Often, this pain originates from an enthesopathic pattern at the anterior inferior tip of the lateral malleolus showing diffuse capsular thickening at the junction between two ligaments. So, lateral malleolar pain may not always be with the ligament body's tear, but could be related to the ligament attachment sites, which are subjected to stress and inflammation. Posterior talofibular ligament. The posterior talofibular ligament is an integral component of the ankle's lateral ligament complex, crucial for stabilizing the ankle joint. It is situated at the back of the ankle, so most doctors need to pay more attention to the posterior talofibular ligament. Evaluation in their examination protocol. It extends from the medial aspect of the lateral malleolus of the fibula to the posterior process of the talus. This ligament is the strongest and least injured among the lateral ankle ligaments, largely due to its protected positioning and robust structure. Damage to the posterior talofibular ligament can lead to posterior instability of the ankle, which may manifest as difficulty walking, especially on uneven surfaces, or pain during activities. Posterior ankle. The posterior talofibular ligament, posterior inferior tibiofibula, and transverse ligament compose the posterior ankle ligament complex. The posterior inferior tibiofibular ligament connects the posterior edge of the fibula's lateral malleolus to the tibia's posterior aspect. This ligament is part of the syndesmosis that binds the tibia to the fibula, providing stability to the ankle joint. The transverse ligament is often considered a deep component or a continuation of the posterior inferior tibiofibular ligament. It extends horizontally from the posterior edge of the tibia to the posterior aspect of the fibula, crossing behind the ankle joint. It is sometimes referred to as the inferior transverse tibiofibular ligament. The posterior inferior tibiofibular ligament and the transverse ligament are integral to the ankle's structural integrity and functional stability, particularly in motions involving twisting or rotating the foot. Posterior tibiotalar ligament. This ligament is part of the deltoid ligament complex, located on the medial posterior side of the ankle. It connects the medial malleolus's posterior edge to the talus bone's posterior part. You could observe the posterior talofibular ligament laterally when observing the dissection image's posterior surface. Medial talocalcaneal ligament. In inferior to the posterior tibiotalar ligament, the medial talocalcaneal ligament connects the medial side of the talus to the sustentaculum tali of the calcaneus. This ligament is situated beneath the deltoid ligament. You could watch symmetry with the lateral calcaneofibular ligament on the lateral side except for the proximal attaching bone. It attaches to the talus rather than the tibia. I will continue to discuss the medial ankle ligament in the next session. Thank you for watching. As esteemed premium members, your support greatly motivates my continued journey in practical pain management. I look forward to seeing you in the upcoming videos.